pay back in to pay for it. And I remember one cashier says to me, "Why'd you do that?" And I said, "Because you're going to come up short in your inventory, number one. And number two, I don't want to be accused of, I don't know, I just have a clear, I want to see for the clear conscience. Just charge me for it and let me pay for it." And so I've done that on various occasions. Now, mind you, there have been other occasions where, you know, I'll walk out and it's not until I, you know, do that and get home and, you know, like the other day, I was, not the other day, but a few months ago, I was not the one taking the things out of the car. And so what happened was, is I had this bag down there and my son put it in the, he just assumed it got charged and everything. He wasn't there with me. So he put it in the car. When I got home, I saw it and I said, I don't think they charged me for that. So sure enough, I looked at the receipt and they did not charge me. So the next time I went in, I said, "You guys didn't charge?" I went to the customer service. Now look, get this. I went to the customer service and I said, "You did not charge me for this. And so I need to pay for this." And the lady looked at me and she goes, "Are you serious?" And I go, "Yeah." And she goes, "This is a return station. This is for items that are returned. I can't help you. I don't know what to do with it." And the supervisor went to me, "Can you come back?" And it was interesting that they didn't know how to handle that. So remember that. You know, remember, now think about this. Let's go back to Yama number one. Yama number one was ahimsa, right? That's acting in consideration all the time, right? Well, if I take something, am I acting in consideration? No, so then I violated two yamas, right? And I can't do, remember that the yamas are made so that you must follow them and not violate any of them, right? But by violating one, you violate all of them. Think about that. If I take something that doesn't belong to me, am I violating number one? And what about number two? What was number two? Truthfulness. So I'm violating it, right? Well, I went back and tried to rectify it. Now, once you go back and try to rectify it, and they can't help you or do something, then you've done your part, right? You've done your part. But the point is to be aware and take action to make it right. And, you know, and then sometimes it doesn't, you know, as much as you do, you try to make it right. Now, let me give you another example. This happened the other day. I bought something from Jerome. I bought this carpet from Jerome, and I have it out, and then last week they delivered another one. So I now have them. I called them up and I said, "I don't need another carpet." I said, "You guys need to come back and pick it up." "Oh, no, no, but it's yours." "No, it's not mine. I have mine sitting here. Do you want me to take a picture and show you?" "Well, we have to look into it because we're sure we only sent you one." "No, you sent me two. I promise you." "So let me take a picture." So they're looking into the matter, right? They're looking into the matter. But isn't that interesting? Pardon me? Yeah. I know, isn't that interesting? You can go to my house right now and see the one rolled up in the garage, and I haven't taken it out of its original package, you know, and called Jerome's, and they said, "Okay, we have to call the delivery center." The delivery center says, "Nope, we didn't send one out." And I said, "You did, guys. It's sitting here. Let me prove it to you." So it's interesting, yeah. But so that's kind of where it is. So any questions, you raise your hand. Somebody raise their hand. Yeah. Well, at some point, if they don't take it back, I am receiving it. Yeah, I mean, but I've done my part. That's what I'm saying. Yes, as soon as trying to alert them, that's different, right? And then if they don't come, as my father used to say, immortal, right? But I will continue to do my part as much as I can, especially for the fact that I don't have anywhere to put this carpet. And it's not just a little carpet. It's a big carpet. And so it's like, okay, so yes.
I would say yes. As long as you do your part,
that's what we need to do. But there aren't many of us out there willing to do our part. Most people will say, hey, sell it or do something, and then you pocket the money. Well, then that's taking advantage of it. Wouldn't you agree that that's taking advantage of the situation? And that means don't take advantage of the situation. Do not take advantage of any situation. This also talks about your physicalness. Don't allow yourself to be taken advantage of, boys, and don't allow yourself to think that it's okay to be taken advantage of. This also has to do with our physical, right? And it tends to happen to girls, but it's happened to guys too. And they've been taken advantage of. So a saying refrains from stealing anything, whether it's a physical thing, whether it's a person, whether it's a thought, whether it's anything else, right? Refrain from stealing anything, even saying, right? How many times have we heard, in the movie I remember there was a while back somebody was dancing in the movie and somebody else took the credit and it was really a different dancer
and it just
made a big deal and she took the credit and, that was a stand-up. That was violating a stand-up. So these lines are for you to believe in and for you to think about things before you take your time. And to teach these to others.
Any other questions?